The ensemble cast in Maestro is incredible. Bradley was really just looking for actors who felt authentic, people that brought the essence of the real people to life.
You know, David, and that's Jerry Robbins.
Hi, guys.
Everybody, I think, felt that privilege of being able to tell the story.
Part of the first conversation with Bradley was like, if we're gonna do this, you know, you've gotta go all in.
I left feeling really blown away by the work Bradley did, both as an actor and a director.
Working with Bradley is electric. He created an atmosphere that was so immersive.
One of real, like, profound naturalism.
The way he was playing Lenny from years before we started shooting was so lived in and so real that you just couldn't help but be drawn into it.
So having really strong actors that could play and could play with him and could play with each other is crucial.
Well, hold on a sec. You made an exception for me.
I thought maybe you were worth making an exception for.
Ooh.
I think Carey Mulligan is amazing. It felt to me to be perfect casting, but then when she actually stepped in front of the camera, it was like, lights out, this woman is incredible. She was able to bring a real quiet grounding to Felicia Montealegre.
When I read it, I thought, this is the closest thing I've read as a screen role to anything I've been lucky enough to do in theater. It had that kind of richness and breadth of an amazing stage heroine.
It's my own arrogance to think I could survive on what he could give.
Just watching the subtleties play across her face is absolutely extraordinary.
Matt Bomer, he gave his soul to the movie, period. I was just sort of in awe of acting with him. What he was able to do by just allowing himself to be, the way he had his head back, and just so sexy and effortless and just so full of love for Lenny.
Sweetie.
There's that scene where Lenny so ignorantly, excitedly introduces Felicia to David Oppenheim, who Matt Bomer plays. I always knew it was gonna be two singles and that Lenny's off camera and you're just watching his impact on these people.
A lot of that wasn't in the script at all. It was the last take we did and he just left the camera on my face. It's a high degree of difficulty. As you're in a period piece, you're playing a historical figure and you're improvising.
I didn't mean to spring that on you.
No, that's all right.
Maybe that was insensitive of me.
No, not at all.
In order for that idea to be able to be pulled off, the actors had to give so much because I'm not cutting away to anything.
Come on, little birdie.
Lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
Oh, it was heartbreaking.
It was just heartbreaking.
Yeah. It was such a huge responsibility to play real people and to play parents of people who are, you
still
know,
alive. Well, we were very lucky with who we got to play Alex, Jamie, and Nina.
All in together in a big robot, slap, clap.
That was the biggest gift. And then their willingness also to put the prep work in. We were all in a WhatsApp chain, you know, as a family, months before we started shooting. That was like one of my favorite things, just sort of talking to them as their parents.
Come here, everyone.
You're trying to capture family members attempting to communicate and bridge the gaps of understanding that they have within themselves and each other. It's just a really unique experience.
Thank you. Come in to talk to me.
Maya has this essence that fully embodied Jamie. I felt she looked so much like her. Even the way that she speaks felt of the time.
At least you know you can trust me.
That's true.
I'm gonna clear.
Sarah Silverman is Shirley Bernstein, and I mean, what a performance.
Okay, now tell me about the suitor.
Bradley knew that she could be funny and larger than life, and I think to be Leonard Bernstein's sister, you would have to be able to hold your own in a room, and Sarah Silverman could really hold her own with Bradley Cooper in a room.
Julia! Julia! I think we need a towel.
It's that you're so distracted all the time.
I've known Sarah for years, and she is not Shirley. So she really had to create this character that was a part of her deep down and that she had observed as a child.
You know, Shirley felt familiar to me.
Let that be fair warning to you and to everyone.
I loved it, just getting her into my bones. You know, she was awesome.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. That I needed a total.
Gideon, his part just grew and grew because I think he was so natural and believable from the moment he met Lenny at the party.
Pun.
Yes, it is pun.
It's a really, really complicated scene. What I wanted to come across was that They were meeting for the first time, but there was also this strange familiarity. I remember when I met my husband for the first time, I felt like I knew him my whole life. And I sort of wanted that to come across in the film, and I think it did.
I just think the whole cast is extraordinary all across the board. Everybody who came in, even for one day, really brought their A-game and just jumped right into the story.
If you go through the list, Miriam Shore, Zach Booth, Jordan Dobson, Michael Urey, Scott Ellis, Tim Rogan, Nick Blamire, Mallory Portnoy, Kate Eastman.
Who did I miss? Have I missed anyone?
Just the piano player.
We're so lucky to work in a city that has the best theater actors. They are trained to pivot and to adapt.
All the actors, if they had an idea coming into it, they were always able to completely upend it if it wasn't really filling what it needed. They were so able to be malleable. It was just the most joyous acting I've ever had in my life.